Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lions Sunday FTL Coffee Time Hour. I, as always, am your host, Regis Philbin. We're gonna get started. I've been thinking, I've had three runs so far. I honestly have thought that at least a couple of those runs have gone pretty well, but it's probably in our best interest to, you know, maybe take the difficulty down a little bit. People have told me that easy has actually gotten harder due to new variations on the final boss. So here's the compromise I'm willing to make. Why don't we go on easy, and as a compromise for that, I'll take the Zoltan Cruiser. I freaking suck at the Voltan or the Zoltan Cruiser, so you will understand the problems that I face here. With the Zoltan Cruiser, I have 29 power and systems at the same time. Complete 2 for layout B. Oh, I already have layout B. What do I need for layout C? That's a damn good question, I guess. But we're gonna play with the, let me think about the layouts here for a second. I kinda like the Adjudicator's layout. I'm just looking. We start with second level doors on this one, which I guess is a difference. We have a missile launcher and a halberd beam, or ion blasters and a pike beam. I actually kind of prefer ion blasters with the pike beam, the reason being we don't have to waste missile parts for it. But yeah, let's roll with this then, and we're gonna name this not the Nether anymore. This will be the feather, because it's lighter than air. Maybe it doesn't really make any sense. Let's get started. Okay, I can't remember if we've actually done a run with the Zoltan Cruiser. I don't think we have, though. Maybe I did one, but it was off camera. That is a beyond theoretical possibility. So we don't need any power in our shields. We also, do we really need, I guess we do need 4 power in our weapons bay because of this crew member. So crew is going to be an extremely important resource here. We also start with 30 scrap, which is enough for me to maybe pick up one bar of power so I can power up my med bay. That was a weird choice for me. But at least now we're starting with everything powered up. Let's begin by going to this distress beacon. I'm not sure how this is going to work out. Obviously, one of our biggest, most important things with the Zoltan Cruiser is going to be getting to one bar of shields, so that we have some additional protection beyond the Zoltan energy shield. You locate a nearby human mining colony where an unknown disease has spread virulently. They are setting up a quarantine to contain it, but a riot has broken out. Let's ignore their request and move on. And the reason I say that is because crew members are super important for me right now, so I really don't want a Zoltan crew member to get, you know, killed by some kind of shitty virus. Alright. So, we are going to make sure that we're landing our ion blasts in here. And then the most important thing, we only need one ion blast to hit for our pike beam to be amazing. So hopefully one of the shots lands on the weapons. Did we kill that missile on the way in? If so, that's actually kind of cool. So I should actually be a little bit more, there we go, this is going to be good. I should be a little bit more prudent with the way that I shoot here. And the reason I say that, that went pretty well. Their missile just bounced off of our energy shield. The way that I shoot should be focused on, you know, one shot on weapons and then one shot to take the shields down. Like, we shouldn't shoot both ion blasts at the same time, I think. That's my philosophy on it. See? Now we have one ion blast. This one should go on the shields quickly, or it doesn't matter where it goes. And the second one should very quickly go on the weapons along with the pike beam, which will then rake across here. Okay, so the second shot isn't gonna go in. That's okay. Just important for me to internalize how we should actually handle this. And yes, we are getting much greater scrap rewards here. Keep in mind that as the Zoltan Cruiser, it is going to cost us something like 100 scrap to actually get to the next bar of shields. Your sensors are picking up a distress call on an encrypted Federation channel. You eventually find a Federation scout being chased by a Rebel fighter. We'll aid the Federation ship and fight the Rebel. They have a missile and a weapon, or sorry, a laser. I really like the Zoltan ship because missiles originally start out for the enemy as being completely useless, which is extremely important because typically missiles are basically the only thing that can get around the typical defense on something like the Kestrel, which is having a fuck ton of shield bars. So one ion shot comes in, it missed, our second ion shot comes in, did not miss, and then we'll go for at least 4 rooms here, Quentin Tarantino style, I suppose, and hopefully we'll injure the weapons enough to take down the missile launcher. Yeah, good enough. And we took their oxygen completely out, which is going to be pretty difficult for them to get over. And I don't even know what we should shoot on here. We should probably still go on the weapons a little bit with our ions, just to make sure that our shield stays up. But they're going to die. They have a very significant problem happening right now. Another ion blast on weapons. We'll fire one on shields quickly, just to make sure it worked. Okay, so the pike beam isn't coming back. Their weapons aren't coming back. We'll fire another one in like so. I can't believe that didn't take their missile launcher offline, but even if they fire a missile, it's just going to bounce off of my energy shields for now. For now. That will change, but that's okay. Just keep their weapons offline, and as soon as the pike beam comes back, this will do it. I really like ions plus beam as far as weapons go. We get 16 scrap just from the detritus, and then we also get a quest marker. Thanks for saving us. The ship is transporting Federation civilians on the run from the rebellion. We don't have much equipment to fight for ourselves. I don't have much to offer, but I can inform you of a hidden Federation base nearby. Perhaps they can assist you more. Okay, that's good to know. It's on the other side of the map. Maybe we'll make a beeline over there, even though it is probably prudent to grind as much as we possibly can here. Okay, there's nothing on this area, or in this area, I should say. We can always jump around in the nebula a little bit. It stops the rebels from getting to us so quickly. An advanced rebel automated ship remains stationed near a small rebel space station. Sensors indicate it's a storage vessel for military goods, so we'll attack it. It has a drone, and drones are actually a hard counter, I think, to the Zoltan energy shield, because every time the drone shoots, it is going to take off a little bit of our power. So we're probably we're going to go on shields first. And then it might actually be prudent to get a shot in. We'll go for the laser. The laser only shoots once. I should have gone for drone control then. But hopefully shields don't come back. They are coming back, so we'll fire one shot on them quickly. We're going to take a little bit of hull damage now because we have nothing to protect ourselves. So, the good news is all the rooms are pretty close together here, so we should be able to get drone, weapon, pilot, and shields in one pike beam. Here we go. That was a very important shot, I would say. So we'll hurt their engines, we'll hurt their shields. But at this point, we're really just waiting for the pike beam to actually recharge. And I don't think they'll be able to repair anything fast enough to possibly scare me at all here. There comes the pike beam, and we'll just be sure. So we lost one hull damage there, that's okay. I could really use like an NG crew member. We got a decent amount of payout there. I could really use an NG crew member to have around for repairs, because as soon as our shield goes down, all of our systems are vulnerable forever. Well, not forever, but until we jump, anyway. You receive a request. All of our military ships have been destroyed or damaged during the rebellion. However, there have been reports of a Mantis war camp. Only a few jumps from us. Can you help? Sure, we'll give it a try, and they'll give us some scrap as a result, which will allow me to pick up our first bar of shields if I just depower the medbay. Bingo bango. There we go. We've got one bar of shields. In addition, there's no way we are getting to that Mantis war camp. But they gave us scrap for it anyway, so lucky me. Alright, so this is our quest beacon. They repaired our hull and gave us a little bit of scrap. That's actually not worth that much. But we'll jump into the nebula here because we're having such an easy time so far. Keep in mind we are playing on easy, but it scales quickly, shall we say, as you get further and further into the game. The difficulty, that is. So we're in the nebula. Is it just Ion Storm? Yeah, just sensors hurting us. Or sensors not being active, I should say. So if I just keep the enemy weapons completely down, they basically have no chance here. And by basically, I mean they literally have no chance here. I am almost amazed that we didn't kill them just in the first pike beam there, but that's okay. We are not at risk. And I know some people will be mad that I'm on easy, but also if I was on normal with the Zoltan ship, I wouldn't do very well at all. This is just a way to kind of increase my familiarity with what's happening with the Zoltan cruiser, hopefully unlock some new stuff, or at least have a chance to maybe get my confidence up a little bit. So, we did get... I bet we can do one more jump here. We got a burst laser Mark 1. I believe that will only do one shot then. Let me see for a second. We could trade two missiles for three drone parts? Sure, why not? Okay, it shoots twice per charge. I don't know how long it takes to charge, but is it better than the pike beam? Let me look at the charge time quickly. You know, I'm just going to go ahead and say that it's not better than the pike beam, but we can maybe sell this and pick up a better burst laser later, or we could have the burst laser in addition to the pike beam and not have any ion blasts, but the ion blasts are way, way better for me right now, so I don't know. Oh, you can still jump to the exit from here. Okay, we'll try this out. We'll see. This has been a pretty lucrative first floor, but maybe I'm not going to do what I necessarily thought might be possible with that burst laser. It's nice to get, though. We got the scrap in addition to it. And now we should probably, with 63 scrap, you know what? Okay, 1 second. Scanners are showing intelligent life forms on a nearby planet. No match for them can be found in the database. We'll investigate. You land a small shuttle in an enormous field whose only occupants are small, brightly colored, six-legged, horse-like animals. Could they be what your scans picked up? Let's try to communicate peacefully. Hey, we got an NG crew member, which is exactly what I asked for, and some more scrap missiles and fuel. All right, NG, you were going to be on these shields. And we should save our layout here. We've got a really nice situation going. And with 74 scrap, I'm going to pump up our engine power a little bit here. I don't know why I pumped it up so much. That's actually... We can still only get to two bars, but I guess maybe we'll focus on reactor power next. And we'll go into the rebel-controlled sector. Actually, you know what? The nebula is actually way easier for us to traverse. Way easier versus the, like, the path we'd have to take for the next 7 sectors, that is. Alright. So yeah, there's no skirting around this nebula. Only 3 of the beacons on here actually aren't nebulas. But our energy shield should stay up in spite of this, which is why I wasn't too worried about it. Okay, so a rebel scout is waiting for us. Let's pause for a second. What are we dealing with? Lightning storm. Or sorry, plasma storm. Your main reactor can only function at half capacity. Still full weapons, which is important. And we still have the energy shield, which is important. But they have a defense drone. I don't know exactly what the defense drone does, but we'll try to shoot one shot here. And see if they break it with their defense drone. They don't. So we're just going to then go on the weapons. So again, we're going to alternate weapons, shields, weapons, shields. Beams are bad against our... are like very good for them against our shields. So here comes a one shot. It lands. So the pike beam, we're going to hit weapons, shields, and the piloting system is probably the best we can do. And a couple of empty rooms. Maybe could have gotten engines instead. That didn't take anything out, much to my surprise. Land some more shots on weapons. Their drones don't mean anything to me. It's really just the shields and the weapons that are a problem at all for us. In fact, I'm gonna land this next shot on the shields just to make sure. Oh, that hit the drone. It short-circuited the drone, but we'll land another shot on shields here. It actually killed the drone. I did not know that if the ion just happens to hit the drone that it'll actually kill it. That's kind of cool, actually. So we'll try this bad boy again. They want to surrender. I'm gonna say no. Just because I'm an asshole, I guess, but also because, remember, they fired on me first, so I don't feel too bad about the treatment that I'm going to impart on them here. They've got a drone back up. Hopefully we don't hit it, and I say that because I wanted to make sure that we could just do that. Didn't require 2 shots, but it could have, so we should pick up more scrap as a result of that. 21. It's okay, we'll get another bar of reactor power, which, as we jump, eventually will mean an extra dodge chance, and dodge chance seems to synergize, in my head at least, intellectually it seems to synergize very well with the energy shield. So, now that we have more power, we can put one more bar into our engines than we previously had. Might be a good idea to buy fuel. There is a store in the nebula here, so I'm trying to maybe get some more scrap. A black market weapons trader spins you a tale of the dangers of the nebula before pushing his wares. We can't purchase his weapon because we've spent our scrap, but we can attack him. And I think that's what we're going to do. Because it's easy mode and... have we been invaded? No. They have a boarding, a boarding bay here. Let's see if I can stop them from hitting us here. One shield came in. Now one ion on their weapons. Good, okay, we took out one thing. And their shields are still down, so we're definitely going to pike beam them here. And this is going to go, weapons, empty room. Nah, I might not hit the empty room. I think we should just go this way instead. Let me try it over here. Oxygen, weapons, oxygen, piloting, boarding, I think is our most likely turn of events. They're going to surrender. I'm not going to accept it, you know? I mean, this time we were the aggressors, so now my excuse is that I'm just in character, right? Let's see if we can take out their beam before it hits us. Our shields are—I shouldn't say our shields. Our energy shield is down, but that should be okay. Okay, pike beam will kill them here because the beam doesn't miss. Wonderful. So far, so good. We're kind of doing very well offensively. We got a system repair drone and way more scrap than I originally anticipated. That's good news. Whoa, 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 whoa! What the? There was. We did get boarded. Holy shit, I had no idea. Alright, medbay's gotta get powered up. I seriously had no idea. Wow, I am exceptionally lucky. We're gonna heal up here, and I'm a dummy. But we are also gonna upgrade our doors. Like so. And they'll have enough power to do that, so that's fine. Alright, let's take a sip of our coffee. Almost lost a very, very important crew member due to me being an idiot. That's not, you know, exceptionally rare, I suppose. Coffee's a little too hot. Let's move on. Guess I shouldn't have spent scrap, given that the store is so close by, but I could sell weapons to go to the store as well, if I have to. Alright, so far so good. We've got another plasma storm, so our reactor's only going to work at half capacity. A rock-armored transport nearby. It looks to have lost its bearings, but when you hail them, they grow suspicious. Whatever life form you are, we find you repugnant. We seek no aid. Leave now. They have missiles. Don't really bother me. Lasers bother me a little bit more. But we'll say repugnant. Arm the weapons. That's what you get for being space racist, you fucking dicks. So, we don't need our bar of shields yet. We can instead just get by with our ion blasters. So, let's get one armed on the shields. And then one on the weapons. Please take them out before they shoot. Oh, they got 2 shots off. One missed, thankfully. So one goes on the shields again, and then pike beam is ready to... Two goes on the shields again. It's just a failsafe, basically, and then the pike beam is ready to cause them some serious problems. So I'm thinking we probably want to hit oxygen, weapons, pilot, shields, engine. But weapons is most important, so let's just make sure we definitely get them there. Alright, so we'll go on shields again. They got two more shots in. Both hit. The good news is, if I want to, I can take our power away from the ion blasts as their shields stay, like, perfectly down. And then, put my power back into shields and really cause them some, serious problems getting around my first bar of shields. But they're dead, so it doesn't really matter because the pike beam is super strong. More scrap. Wonderful. We can get another bar of reactive power easily. And we won't upgrade, or we won't, use that bar of reactive power yet because we can't really see how it's gonna go. Although we are in danger here. Let me look at this for a second. They have drones, a laser, maybe an ion weapon, it's hard to tell. We're gonna attack the ship. Two drones, but just a laser apart from that. So where are we gonna put our power here? like that, actually. We have one extra bar of power. So we'll probably upgrade our engines again soon. So or maybe we'll go for a second bar of shields. Oh, no, wait, oxygen is depowered. Never mind. This is fine. Oxygen was at 51%. Man, was that down for that whole last fight and I didn't notice? What can I say? It's a little early in the morning over here. There we go, landed a shot. I assume their laser's bad, and it is, but we'll still focus on it, I suppose. Their shields are still down, so this is going to cause them some problems. We're just gonna hit all of their, like, vital systems here. And even, you know, hitting, like, oxygen and medbay is possibly more important than hitting the weapons at this point. Just fire both of these in here. It doesn't really matter where they land. We should probably land an ion blast on engines, I guess, just so they have less of a dodge chance, but I'm pretty sure the beam just never misses, so it doesn't really matter in the whole scheme of things, because they're going to be dead basically right here. They're going to surrender to give us missiles and scrap, but we will not accept surrender. That's what you get for being space racist. Wait, that was the last people, but you get the idea. Okay, I mean, we should go to the store, probably, but instead I'm just gonna keep jumping. And we'll get as much scrap as possible before going to the store. So can we go like, boop, boop, that's gonna cause us to backtrack. So we'll just go to the store now. I think we get rid of Burst Laser Mark 1. Maybe we could buy another weapon, so let's look at what we've got here. A hacking unit would be awesome. Teleporter could be awesome. Drone control unit could be awesome. More crew would be cool. I think what I'm gonna do is sell, our Burst Laser for 25. And sell our system repair drone. And I can't quite buy a hacking unit. But I think a hacking unit is actually super important for us to get. So if I have to backtrack, that's fine. Just give me 2 scrap here so I can at least buy the hacking unit in the first place. We're going to attack the pirate. Because this means that it's going to give us a... They have some nasty weapons. But it does mean that it's going to give us a chance to get the scrap necessary to pick up a hacking module and make our ship a little bit better. Seems like a smart idea to me. We'll see. Let's see if we can take out their weapons before they... Oh, we missed. And that really, really cut a hole in our, Oh, there we go. 1 second. I do have an important train of thought there, but that really cut a hole in our, Zoltan energy shields, unfortunately. There we go. Oh, they've highlighted now how many rooms you hit with the pike beam. That's really nice. There we go. We'll just go for these 4. We just want to make sure weapons go down so we don't end up in a much worse position than we otherwise would be in. They're gonna stick with their beam, which is fine. Nothing wrong with that. The beam is gonna do more damage against our energy shield than their laser would. And now we're gonna make sure their weapons stay down, even though their beam is gonna fire here. This time, maybe we wanna go like that. Maximum of 4 rooms probably that you can hit. So we want like this permutation. No, we want that. That's fine, that'll do. Alright, so they're gonna try to escape, and they also want to surrender. I'm gonna accept their offer, and you might be saying, Northernlion, why are you such a big old, you know, slobbery coward about everything? Not to use the P word. That's because... I'm gonna buy all the fuel here, too. That's because I wanted to make sure that we got all the scrap necessary, necessary to buy the hacking unit, I should say. Otherwise, I could have found myself in a position where, they got away. However unlikely it was, there was a chance, and that would have been bad for me. So I'm going to depower engines 1 just to power up hacking. Because we can now like disable enemy weapon systems like right from first blush, which would be amazing for us. And I want to use the hacking system more anyway. I haven't used many of the new systems as much as I would like. Your sensors have picked up a refugee ship drifting through the system, no doubt one of the many fleeing the rebel advance. It doesn't appear to have detected you, or else it's trying to avoid notice. Let's hail them, and they want to trade fuel for missiles. I'll do it. I don't know if I'll have a missile launcher in the future. Why not, right? Gains from trade, man. And now we're going into the Zoltan-controlled sector. Pardon me. You'll have to excuse me for a second. No. No, you will not. But pardon me, I'm going to take a sip of my coffee here as we choose to jump. Probably to this distress beacon. Although, on this side of the map, there's like so many more beacons that actually I think this is probably the best one for us. Let's caffeinate for a second here. Okay. It's a tourist trap. Too bad you don't have time to visit. Well, your business is going to suffer pretty greatly in probably about 6 turns, if I had to guess. Alright, here's our fight. They've intruded upon us already, and there is a super shield, or a Zoltan shield. How do we want to fight them? Pretty easy. NG just get in the medbay, and all of these doors open the F up. And we'll micromanage people as necessary to move them around. But first, let's use our hacking unit. Costs a drone part. I totally forgot about that. Okay, super shield prevents hacking. So we're gonna have to take out their super shield first. So let's just make sure we've got our weapons to fire or set to fire as soon as possible. Zoltan, you'll get in the med bay. This will be a problem for them. Zoltans are not really they're fighters, not lovers. Oh, I left the weapons room, so I actually don't have enough to use 2 ion blasts. That's me being an idiot, but that's okay because they're not gonna be able to take out one bar of the actual power. So let's get ion blast set to go as well. Their shields are probably, like, exactly in line with ours. Their intruders are all dead. So let's wait for the oxygen to come back up here. It is indeed powered up. One more ion blast and we can actually hack them. But we might not want to hack them now that I realize that it actually costs us a drone part every time. We might want to save that for more pressing matters, shall we say. So now that we're not going to die due to not having oxygen, let's get everything powered up here. Pike beam is still not good to go. We shouldn't use pike beam yet. We should just wait until ion blast is ready. With their... they actually could get around our shields, and they did there. It's the first damage we've taken in a little while, though, so I feel okay about it. Now, let's see if we land our shot in here. We did. So we're going to fire one more at their weapons with the Ion Blast, but we're also going to do a Pike Beam basically all the way up here. That's going to cause them some really serious problems. All right, so all they have left is their beam. Their beam should not be able to do any damage to us. So we'll just make sure we've got everything hit here, and we're going to land the Pike Beam in exactly the same spot next time. Like that, and that'll do it, I think. They were kind of an asshole about the whole thing, but that's okay. 37 scrap for us. What do we get? I think one bar of reactor power is pretty smart right now. Keep our dodge chance up. Again, the more shots we dodge, the better we are, or the better off we are, because our energy shield lasts longer, which means the missiles stay terrible. Asteroid fields are bad for super ships, or super shields, I should say. But because we're both in the same boat here, I don't feel so bad about it, so... We'll just get our ion blasts going quickly. Because of the asteroids, I really doubt we'll have to wait for like a second recharge of our pike beam, if that makes sense. Oh, their missile missed. That's very good for us. Alright, this should take out their shields. And it did. So now it's pretty much exactly the same ship layout, so we're just gonna do exactly the same thing we did prior, and they actually can hit us with a missile now. So we've got to be a little bit cautious about that. But their shields are completely down, so I almost just expect asteroids to take them out before anything else happens. We'll see. They missed with their missile as well, so that's great. Great for me, at least. 36 extra scrap, 2 missiles and a drone part. We're just gonna get those drone parts up basically as quickly as we can. And the reason for that is so that we have a ton of hacking modules that we can use, or a ton of ability to use our hacking modules when we move ahead in further sectors. You jump into a debris field that used to be a Zoltan cruiser. Unfortunately, its NG escort takes you for the attacker and retaliates. They refuse all hails. It's a nasty ship, 2 bars of shields. Let's try out our hacking unit, and we're gonna land this just here. On their shield unit, just to completely take it out when we get the chance. We're also going to fire our Ion Blast to see if we can just take it out like that. But I would also love, if we get the chance, to disable their shields for the first time that our Pike Beam is ready to go. Which is very, very soon. So we should get about 4 seconds of invincibility here. I didn't even click it. The Ions landed on it. Here we go. We're going to hack it. I clicked it. They're being hacked. Is that what's happening? Yeah, okay. Shields are completely down. Now, there we go. We'll just hit these 4 rooms right here. And that is going to cause a very substantial problem. I like using the, What are they shooting at here? This is weird. I like using the, hacking module, because once it's hacked, it doesn't actually cost any more drone parts to hack it in the future. Which is great, and not necessarily the norm, I guess, for a lot of subsystems. So I really apologize to this NG that's in there. Because he's, you know, he's doing his best, but let's be honest, he's got a tall order here. An uphill battle. We'll take out their shields again, just to aggravate him, basically. And they can't even keep their weapons online. This is how powerful the hacking unit can be in the proper hands. And there it goes. Should pay more close attention to the pike beam and when we use it, but that's okay. Alright, so next bar of shields is up, and we can do that just by depowering our engines one. And we'll probably go for reactor power next. Yes, I know there's a store over here, but I want to, again, hit as many beacons as we can before the store. The comm before the store, if you will. Your sensors are picking up a single life form. Let's go down to the surface to investigate. You find a man living alone in a cave. From the appearance of his wrecked ship, it seems he's been here for many years. He looks healthy, but his mental state is questionable. Let's bring him back. He almost always kills somebody. This time he just did damage to our hull and broke our hacking system. That's actually not so bad. Occasionally, he'll become another crew member. Would have been nice to have someone man the sensors, I guess, just so they hit second level, but this gives me a very good excuse to recaffeinate here. And this, it's going very well for us so far in the third sensor here. Two bars of shields, plus the Zoltan energy shield. Really good weaponry and a hacking module is better than I would expect on a normal run, but we're not on a normal run, are we? We're on an easy run. Important to remember, even if we win, there will always be that asterisk associated with it. Maybe an obelisk as well, if we end up learning something here, which I doubt. Their ship, just looking at the weapon configuration, basically has no chance to do damage to us. Even if the beam could be annoying, but apart from that, there's not really much that can be done here, on their end at least. So yes, oh, you actually can hit 5 rooms with the pike beam. I'm glad I learned that before the end of the episode at least. This is going to be a problem for them. Everything on their ship is hurt except for that empty room. And I don't think they're going to be able to repair it in time. I wonder if you can repair through ion blasts? I actually don't know the answer to that question. They'll surrender, but it's not worth it. They might have given us more fuel for the surrender. Let's see. Nope, they gave us the same amount. So let's get one more bar of reactor power just so we can engine up a little bit. And we're good to go. Do we want to go to the store now? From the store, we can get to the exit. So I think one jump will put them there. I think we can make it if we go this way. I keep spending, that's the problem. So I don't have anything to actually spend on the store. Well, you know what? We will buy as much fuel as we can here. So store be damned. Much appreciated nonetheless. But we're just going to leave. We don't have anything to sell either. So I'd rather have an extra chance to get more scrap here. We will participate in their study. Oh, okay. That's the Zoltan option. I'm going to depower one bar of engines. And then I want to keep our weapon power high. But when our Zoltan leaves... He's gonna end up, one second here. When our Zoltan leaves, he's gonna take a bar of power out of the weapon room, and then we'll just power it back up. Oh, we don't need it because of the surplus reactor power we had. Okay, that's good. That's good news. NG's probably gonna have to do the same. Let's make sure we land in our shots here. Our energy shield is still completely up, so I anticipate basically no problems here. There we go. They hit our missiles. Or sorry, they hit us with a missile, but it didn't really do anything. Let's make sure we land one there. Pike beam is about to come up. We're gonna use it right away, actually, because we have the opportunity to do so. So, 4 rooms, and they're pretty vital ones here. That's gonna annoy the crap out of them. No question about it. We just had a Zoltan die. I imagine the NG not gonna be too far behind him. If he doesn't... Like, how did he get on our ship? Oh, I guess it was through the special event. It wasn't actually like a boarding bay, so that's fine. They have an ion weapon, but it's not going to do anything for them as we just finish them off here with the pike beam. Okay, never mind. In hindsight, I do wish that I had kept up the vigilance with going for their weapons and shields, but again, let's look at the situation here. All of their systems are basically screwed. Especially if we land that shot, which we did, and this one should do it then when the pike beam's ready to go. Alright. What do we get? 31 scrap and a defense drone and another payout as well. Let's go back to your rooms here, ladies and gentlemen. And we have a little bit of extra reactor power. Can't go to the store. Very unlikely we'll be able to go to the store. Let's just go to the exit. Better to not risk anything, I think. And we could maybe get a third bar of shield soon, but we might want to save our money and buy a weapon. Is my thinking. We'll go to Sector 4, and this is going very, very well so far, no question about it. I'm not saying I'm a great player. I'm saying we're playing on easy, but that's fine too. But another great weapon, and then saving some power to be able to use it, would really allow us to tear up enemy ships quite greatly. A ship without life forms within a nearby dense asteroid field is giving out the distress call. Shall we investigate? Yes! We got 56 scrap as a result of that, which is crazy good for, like, the fourth sector. Halfway through the game, roughly. Free system repair drone, as well as some more scrap. So yes, we're absolutely going to go to the store here, because we should be able to buy something, at the very least, to improve our chances. Alright, they only sell drones on this page. On the other page, they only sell crew members. We can get we could get cloaking. We sell our... Do they sell a drone control unit? Sorry. They do. It's always nice to have defense drones, too. Let me think about cloaking. Cloaks the ship, adding 60 to your evasion and preventing the enemy ship from locking on with their weapons. Sure, let's prioritize cloaking. We'll sell our system repair drone, and we'll have to sell our defense drone, too. That's alright, we've decided that we're gonna go with this cloaking device instead. That's fine. Yeah. Okay. That's cool. We'll stick with that for now. So, our cloaking device has no power. So, one thing I will just quickly do is get more reactor power and do that. And our weapons still charge during the cloak, which is the important part, I think. Let's jump. Not to this store. We'll jump to this beacon we've already been to, because this one's just a dead end. And we're gonna be, you know, the Rebel fleet's gonna be hot on our tail here, but I think this is pretty good for us. This is a lot of subsystems to manage, but that's okay. This one gives me a few more options for escape if necessary. And I'll try to get some practice here. There is a single ship at this FTL beacon. They hail you. We could really use some help. Our FTL navigation system is shot. Can you help us get to a nearby station where they can patch us up? Yeah, sure. We'll get a quest marker and 3 fuel. And that's on the way, more or less. Let's ignore that distress beacon and just make our way to that beeline quest beacon instead. Your sensors have picked up a refugee ship. We'll hail them and we'll trade with them. We'll lose 3 missiles for 8 fuel. That's a great trade for us right now because we don't even have a missile launcher. And we're just gonna chart a course now to actually hit a couple of beacons. This scares the shit out of me because now we're in a solar flare area. This beacon has been placed too close to a supergiant class M star. The ship will gradually overheat until you get out of here or die. A pirate, apparently oblivious to the danger of the sun, moves in to engage. Okay. Okay, yeah, this should be fine. I'm just thinking about how I want to deal with this. We could cloak. And I think if we cloak, it gives us what? Oh, I can't look at my ship. I think what we'll do is we'll fire our first 2 levels of ion blast, then we'll cloak, and then we'll have a chance to get ion and pike beam back in time. So I just fired both of these, then we cloak. And this won't protect us from the solar flares, obviously, but that's okay. Okay, so our cloaking runs out really quickly. We're gonna want to upgrade that as soon as we can, in all likelihood. Oh, they did fire a missile, but that shouldn't matter. Pike beam will be able to land on some very important rooms here. Come on, you know you want to... There we go, that's gonna be good enough. That's gonna really, really inhibit their chances here. Plus, they missed with their missile shot. So we still have a full bar of shields, but really what we're concerned about primarily here is the fires from the solar flare, obviously. Could hack some of their systems, but really we've done enough damage to them for now, I would say, basically, without question. Let's just keep hitting exactly the same subsystems, basically. And as a result, they're gonna find themselves in a very difficult position, especially with their engine inhibited. But here comes the solar flare. Where's the fire? It's in the engine room, which is annoying because it's going to be difficult for us to get out of the way, but we'll just let Mother Nature do its thing. We do come out of cloak when we fire. I assumed that would be the case because that's how, you know, cloaking works in every video game ever. There we go, another good shot, and only need to hit 4 rooms to make this happen. They're going to surrender a little late for that. They would die even if I accepted that surrender, so... I hope they're not too mad at me. What happened? 46 scrap. That's pretty good. We're gonna jump out of the way. And the reason we're doing that before repairing is because we don't want to put ourselves at risk of, like, another fire happening. So, a distress signal is happening. They need someone to fix or disable it. We'll help, and then we'll use our, NG crew to remotely repair it, and then we just get a free 54 scrap. Well, it's not free. We had to get the NG crew member, but you get the idea. Cloaking, only costs 30 to upgrade. That seems kind of crazy. We'll do that, and then we'll get another bar of reactor power, and we'll put it in there. So now that doubles our cloaking efficacy, I think. Let's repair our engines. Well, I take a second to recaffeinate. So I do want to get a third bar of shields up in addition to our energy shield. I think this is a run where we have a pretty good chance of actually beating the rebel fleet. On easy, admittedly, but maybe that's the first stepping stone, right? So it'll cost us 40, 60, about 150 to actually get that third bar of shields and the necessary reactor power. That's okay, we can get that fairly easily. We're getting a huge scrap rewards. I don't feel great about it because it is on the easy mode, but whatever. Better to learn. Free reactor power is awesome. Now it only costs us 125. Better to actually just learn how to play the game, as long as this doesn't engender bad habits, than have my pride and still be terrible at it. This should give us a chance to jump and escape while still checking out this last beacon. We got a Pegasus missile, which might be amazing, and some extra scrap. It was a little close to get away here, but sure, the Pegasus missile is amazing. Especially if we end up coming to blows with an enemy. We're just going to pick up that second bar of shields right now. Especially if we end up coming to blows with an enemy that has drones that would block ions but don't block missiles. Does that even happen? I don't know. But we'll recaffeinate here, and I'm feeling pretty good. Might be a good idea to get three more bars of weapon power and just be able to use this in addition to all of our weapons without microing. Because having a missile that you can just come out with straight away is going to be a huge bonus for us, especially if we're cloaked for 10 seconds at like the start of a fight and give it time to recharge. But it does take 3 power, which is nuts. I'm going to buy, you know, we can afford it. We'll buy 6 more fuel. 30 fuel should be enough for maybe the whole game, but at least for the next little while. Alright, what are we dealing with here? You receive a message, this area is off limits, submit your ship to processing. What do they have? Ion beam beam. That is dangerous with respect to my... with respect to my energy shields, I don't know. It depends on the power of their ion weapon. It may or may not be actually able to do damage beyond my shields. Oh, we hurt them really well with that first ion blast. But we're going to get hurt as well. Yeah, there goes our energy shields. So let's land a couple of shots here. First one lands. Let me look. Missed. Second one, land. Hit. Okay. So we don't want to use pike beam. Instead, what I'm going to do is actually cloak so they can't fire at me for a second. We could hack, but I prefer to save our drone parts. Now, with both ion blasts being back, we're going to fire both of those at the enemy shields because it doesn't matter where we fire them. Oh, we didn't come out of cloaking there. That's weird. What is also weird is that somehow I didn't take their shields completely down with 2 ion shots. Maybe one missed and I didn't notice. There we go. Their shields are down, so we're just going to make sure we hit as many rooms as possible here, like so. There we go. 5 rooms, and that's bad for them. Okay, so we're not going to take any damage here, almost positively. Let's see. As long as we can keep their shields down, and one ion blast will be enough to do that. Maybe. We're about to be able to cloak again, so I'm going to do it. Our shields are kind of hurt, but this will give them a second to recharge and get over the ion blast. Let's land a couple of shots in here with the cloaking. Both landed, but didn't quite take out the shields. I don't know if they have, like, ion defense or something. I knew our ion weapons wouldn't last, like, that long from, like, a, you know, staying relevant position. But I don't know why they won't last that long, which is kind of a dangerous position of ignorance to be in. 53 extra scrap is wonderful. We already got our extra bar of, where does this one go? Only the nebula, huh? We already got our third bar of shield power, so I think we honestly might want to just start pumping into weapons here. You come to a Zoltan trade and supply hub, everything the weary traveler needs, provided they have the right documentation. We could talk our way in, or we could present his official documentation of our Zoltan crew and pay the entry fee. Sure, let's do that. Cost us 10 scrap. And we can, it's just a store. Okay, good to know. We could sell the Pegasus missile. It only sells for 30. That's not that much, actually. We can get a backup battery. Honestly, I think the backup battery is a pretty good purchase. So basically, whenever we want, we just click this, and at level 1, it gives us... I guess we can look here. At level 1, it gives us an extra... Where are you there? An extra 2 bonus power, which saves me from having to upgrade the reactor twice if I want to use the Pegasus missile. We still need to upgrade it a lot to be able to use the Pegasus missile, because we need to get the extra 3 bars of weapon power, in all likelihood at least, but it's nice to have, I guess. Alright, so there's a Mantis ship. They have a lot of weapons. They're also going to board us, almost certainly. I wonder if I cloak right away. Here's what I'm going to do. Backup battery. Pop that off, just so we can get our medbay active for like 30 seconds, and also extra dodge chance. But then I'm going to cloak. And they can't board when I'm cloaked, which is very nice. Let's see. Okay, 1 bar here. One eye on here, one eye on here. Oh, missed and missed. That's really nasty. I don't know what to do now. Okay, we'll take a second. One here, hit. Just one, two of you hit. It didn't take out as much as I thought it would. They missed us too, though. I really don't want, we could hack their shields, of course. But I don't want to use a drone part if I don't have to. This is perfect. All right, take out all of the offending systems. Okay, so we've taken out their weapons a little bit. I'm worried about their missiles, and I think justifiably so. They have boarded us, I think, just now. We'll cloak, and we'll also fire some ions in. Shields and weapons seem relevant. Did they? They did board us. Okay, they're going for oxygen, which is a dangerous one for everybody on board the ship, including the intruder, unfortunately for them. We do have an NG, so we should be able to repair if necessary, but for now, pike beam will come back up, and we'll just land this in exactly the same setup that we did before. Alright, so they're in a very... Yes, he stopped just before. They're in a very, very bad position. And we're probably gonna have to take our man out of the engine room. That's not a big deal at all. Pike beam's ready. This should kill them. Alright, wonderful. Now this Mantis, as far as I'm concerned, should become my crew member, but maybe that's me being short-sighted. Our Zoltan will just be able to kill him. We should probably send him to the medbay, but I don't think it's a really big deal in the whole scheme of things. Let's jump over here. I really think that we have a genuine chance of doing very, very well on this run. So intruders have come on board already. Three Zoltan. Our NG will just leave the shield room. Like, NG, where are you here? Elizabeth, get to the medbay. We don't even need to power up the medbay for now, because as soon as we put a Zoltan in there, it'll automatically power up. And I'm just going to let them fire on the shields for a little bit, and then when they try to escape, this room will already be like, have the oxygen completely sucked out of it. So we're just going to cloak up, and then obviously, you know, they've got a lot of weapons, I've got a lot of weapons. It's going to take a while for us to disable each other's energy shields here. Not as long as I actually originally thought, I guess. One of the Zoltan is already dead. This is, you know, another shot we're just going to have to take here. One bar of their shields is gone, and they're all dead. Wonderful. We'll just wait for the oxygen to come back up. They're gonna shoot a bomb at us. It just broke our energy shield. That's fine. No problems there. Don't miss. Don't miss. Hey, two good hits, but they still are, with one bar of shields, the pike beam can't get through. And they actually hit our weapons there. So we're gonna cloak, and we're gonna do that to give us our, give ourselves a chance to repair here. Also, might want to use the backup battery for a second, and, that'll get our shields back up to, three bars. And the weapons should be repaired very soon. There we go. Get the pike beam back up. And just land some ion blasts on their weapons and shields again. NG can go back to the shield room. We have the power to keep the medbay active, but there's no point. Their bomb must have missed, luckily. Okay, so just keep this up. We should be fine. We took a little hull damage. It's just, it's weird to get used to taking damage again. Because I'm like, it's been so long since we actually got hit by something. You should come into the sensor room and fix that up. We've, cloak, or backup battery has been hit? Okay, I thought cloaking got hit, actually, but backup battery getting hit is not so bad. Oh, cloaking did get hit, sorry, it was the other way around. I almost want to just use a hacking module here and just go on their shields, to be honest with you. Or go on their weapons. Let's fire it. We'll fire it on shields, just so we can for sure get in there. They missed. Okay, good. With pike beam active already, we're gonna hack their shield room. They're gonna get hacked, and boom, okay. Wait, that should have taken out their shields. Should it not have? There we go. And why is pike beam not active? Not enough power? Oh, because the backup battery stopped working. Okay, get fully charged. I can wait. This is dangerous. Their bomb did hit the sensor room again. Pike beam's so close, so close. Just keep hacking, man. All right, partner. Keep on hacking, baby. You know what time it is? Hey, we did hit their weapons too. Okay, so that's something. This has been a poorly handled fight. We're gonna cloak up. Do we still get hit by the missile? No, it missed. Okay. Go fix the hacking bay because we still have a part over there that I would love to do something important with. If we could get it fixed. Okay, pike beam's back up, so same old system here. There we go. Okay. This is bad for them. We're just gonna hack their shields. They're gonna stay down, even though this Zoltan is doing his best to repair them. It's a thankless job, but someone's got to do it. Why did the hacking not work very well? That's a good question for a smarter man than myself. They're gonna have two bars of shields again. What the heck, man? And this is what I'm really worried about, is these missile, or like our lack of missile defense is a real problem. That's basically what dismantled us during this fight. Not that we lost or even did that poorly, but yeah, it was just a serious like missile defense problem. If we had a drone, that wouldn't be an issue. But I sold my drone parts to pay for cloaking. So, I mean, the good news is we do have an energy shield, which protects us from missiles to start with. But I don't know if that's going to be enough. Okay, just one second. We'll power down engines a little bit. Everyone get into the med bay here. Like so. We're going to have a little bit of a talk. Figure out what's going on. Make sure that everybody's good to go here. Well, you know what, Astid? You, what are you on? You're a pilot. Oh, you don't need to be healed anyway. Okay, everyone back to base. Now, how much do we need to get our next bar of weapon power? 50, 75, 90. That is 215. I can pick up two bars and a bar of reactor power. And then if I wanted to, I could depower one ion blast to get Pegasus working. I don't want to, though. So this is just setting the stage for us eventually being able to use the Pegasus missile. And I don't want a micro. I want to use it in addition to our weaponry, so we're still super strong. Now, they have a drone. Drones are bad for energy shields, but luckily, a good counter to drones is a cloak. So, a third level of cloak would also be awesome for me, I think, if I can make that happen. Probably will not be possible, but it's nice to know that it's a theoretical chance. Okay, and we can probably... We can hit the engines. We might even be able to hit all five rooms, but it would be close. Mostly, I just want to make sure that I'm taking out drones, weapons, and shields. And we didn't take out the drone, but that drone is not going to be able to do any damage beyond just taking out our initial energy shield, so I'm not too concerned about the whole thing that we've got going on here. Make sure to cloak again as soon as it comes off cooldown, and we should be able to, on our next blush, we'll be able to pike beam them. And there we go. Alright, so basically the same thing. They didn't repair at all. I mean, because it's an automated like scout drone, I didn't expect them to repair, but they are just sitting ducks right now, basically. And we have 33 missiles and 15 drone parts, which seems like a very nice position to be in when it comes to ensuring that you don't find yourself in a really terrible spot with respect to running out of resources anytime soon. I think, at least. We can't get to the exit from there, so I think we'll just jump this way. We're on Sector 5? Sector 5, I think. Mm-hmm. Okay, it's a refugee ship. We'll hail them. We can trade 2 fuel for 5 missiles. Sure. I mean, it's a good trade. Normally, missiles cost a little bit more than fuel, so we'll go to the slug-controlled nebula. Maybe I can get another slug on board our ship. We'll see. For now, we're just going to jump around. And nebulas don't bother me as much because we have Zoltan, so our power concerns are a little bit less than they would be otherwise. Just a little bit. All right, this is a nasty slug assault ship here with a charge ion, I think, an ion, and a missile launcher. So we're gonna do a couple of things here. First, we're going to... cloak. Then we are going to use our hacking bay to go on their shields. And the way that it might work, maybe, is maybe one bar of, let's hack them. Maybe one bar of, like, the purple that goes down takes out one bar of shields. No? Okay, maybe just take some time. Did it just not work? Because to me, that appears to have not worked. So what I'm going to do is actually shoot one ion blast, then disable it. Then disable it. You can't disable it? Disable the ion blast, please. Why? I don't have enough system power to use the thing because... Oh, maybe it's because there's a Zoltan in the room? I can disable the other ion blast. That's stupid. There we go. That one's disabled now. Now we should be able to power the Pegasus by taking down engine power a little bit. And now we can just fire a, like, 3 damage missile at their shields instead. I don't know if this is going to do anything. It seems like the ship is extremely well armed. Mind you, so are we, to be honest with you. So we've just mixed up our weapons just a little bit. Oh man, they are doing a number on our shields here. Mixed up their weapons just a little bit. Mixed up our weapons just a little bit, sorry, I should say. And we'll be able to hack them again soon. We'll be able to cloak ourselves again soon. I'm going to fire the Pegasus missile in on their shields. Oh, they have done some damage in here. We did some damage to them too, though. That slug is going to have a really hard time dealing with the fire. Will our NG come back to life in time to put out this and keep our shields alive? Because we have 0 power to our shields right now, which means that cloaking seems like a real smart idea. We'll also fire an ion blast at their shields to hopefully take them down a peg. And I think that they're... Man, this new song is really great, by the way. That slug is like, let me the fuck out of here, but because I hacked them, it actually, like, they have no chance to get out. So that slug is definitely just gonna die. I'm gonna fire another Pegasus missile in, because I don't want to fight in this shitty area anymore. That's wonderful. They're gonna be in a terrible position, especially now that the pike beam is gonna do work. So fuck their piloting system. I want to take out their oxygen. I want these assholes to die. And if we can get their engines too, even better. But no, that's fine. There we go. They're gonna try to escape. I don't blame them, really. Our engines are hurt. That's not the end of the world, man. The end of the world is what they're about to face. So we're gonna try to just land one shot on their engines here, just to keep them grossly inhibited. They landed another shot in our shields. We're taking damage here. Let them live, or we will not accept surrender. Let them live. They gave us 4 fucking fuel. I really expected a little bit more than 4 fuel for letting them live. I expected a weapon, or maybe I would take one of them as a crew member. I should have just stayed ruthless, but instead, I got real ruthy, and that didn't work out too well for me. So we're gonna take a second to have people heal up here. The medbay obviously has no power in it. That was by far the hardest fight we've had so far. And that's okay. I'll take a sip of my coffee. Sometimes it's important to be tested. We tested the Pegasus missile. It works out quite nicely. Really good at starting fires, apparently. Combined with the hacking module, if you like hack the shields, and then the Pegasus missile starts a fire or a breach, and then they're trapped in the room because hacking makes the doors not work. I had a feeling that would probably happen, to be honest with you. Thank God they gave us that fuel so they didn't explode. But, yeah, if you can keep them locked in the room, and then, fire some, or get them with some fire, then that's a real problem for them. So I'm gonna go to one beacon before we go to the store. It's a little risky, but I'm doing it just so that I theoretically have a more scrap that I can spend, maybe buy something in addition to healing. But I'm realizing now that they have 4 weapons and I might be in a very, very dangerous position here. I'm gonna disable 1 ion blast. This is par for the course. Disable 1 ion blast. Disable 2 engines. Go to Pegasus instead. Cloak up. We are also gonna send out a hacking drone to their shield bay. Actually, you know what? We're gonna hack their weapons. Do I need to get like a second level of hacking? That might be it. Oh, we can drain charge from enemy weapons, which might be super useful for us as well. So this will keep their weapons offline. And we can see their charges as well. Oh, that is so useful. To be able to see the charge on the enemy weapons? Is that what that is? If so, they're not really charging up. Oh, it's because the drone just landed. Okay, got it. Pegasus missile is almost ready. When it is, we're gonna hack. Like so, they're almost ready to shoot, so this hack is important. That's gonna drain the charge from their weapons. Awesome. And then we're gonna just fire our first Pegasus missile at the weapons area just to make sure they have no offensive potential. If I end up spending 6 missiles here, fine by me. There we go. Take some of their weapons offline. And I say that because I wanna just, most importantly, make sure that they have no way to do damage to me. And if they have no way of doing damage to me, if the fight takes 10 minutes, I have the resources necessary to back it up. So here comes more missiles. We can cloak as well, so we will. Our energy shield is still up, which is obviously amazing for me. Can I just auto-fire the ion blast, please? Left control plus aim can force a weapon to do the opposite of current setting. I don't know what that means, but sure. Auto-fire forever. On the weapons, for now. Okay, they put their NG in that room. We're gonna hack it in just a second here. Just give it a minute. And there we go, they're about to shoot. And they are gonna shoot. Alright, you know what, we're gonna hack it now. There we go, that's gonna drain their charge, and that should drain it basically to zero. Then we'll land another shot in like this. Both missiles landed, there's a breach, the Mantis was killed. The NG is gonna have to deal with that breach before the weapons can do anything. And Ion Blast still trucking along here. We're gonna be able to cloak again in a second, so we will. Our energy shield is still up. Man, the Pegasus is super useful for us here. And the NG is doing a good job of healing them. But we started a fire and he's been killed, and now their weapon system is gonna be completely offline. And you know what? In all honesty, oh, they're sending more people in there. I was gonna say, like, I don't actually wanna, like, fire another Pegasus missile, but now I kinda do to kill their crew members instead. Why can't we hack them? Probably because they're at zero. Yeah, it's destroyed. They're just gonna die in the fire, and honestly, I think that their ship is just gonna die in the fire. So I'm not gonna fire any more Pegasus missiles or anything. I'm just gonna let fire take its course, basically. And I'm pretty sure that this is just going to completely destroy the enemy ship. So we'll just hang out. Because I don't want to spend another missile if I could just not spend another missile. They have, like, the most amazing fire protection of all time, apparently. Like, they're taking zero hull damage. Holy shit, they have, like, auto fire suppression or something. They completely put it out. Well, you know what? I almost just want to put them out of their misery here. We're going to land a Pegasus missile on their shields. Two Pegasus missiles, I guess, technically. And they're dead. That was a great fight. I had a lot of fun with that one, as you could probably tell. And 64 scrap is awesome. There's 90 that we're going to use to get to the point where we can also have our Ion Blast working if we have another bar of reactor power. But before that, we want to heal up just a little bit at least. So now we can see the power that we have here. It's kind of nuts. Shield charge booster and stealth weapons would also both be amazing. But first, we're going to fix as much as we can. Which is basically the amount that I would want to fix ideally in a perfect situation to begin with. Lots of great weapons there. It's the Vulcan. This laser weapon takes a long time to warm up. Oh, so it's a chain Vulcan. Basically, the way chain weapons work, the first time they fire, it takes the most amount of time, and then from that point onwards, they charge faster. It's really useful, because they start charging slower than, like, a burst laser, for example, but then by the end, they go, like, 60% faster, which is nuts. I'm gonna caffeinate for a second. A heavily damaged Federation ship is hiding in the nebula of this beacon. Before you have time to make contact with them, they fade into the nebula. Let's follow them. Sure. Your search is hopeless. Whatever. That actually provides me with some hope, because we're not in danger. Reactor power is the next big thing, I think, for us. You're surprised to find a ship without slug markings stranded all the way out here. And move in to provide assistance. When you see the pirate insignia on the hull, you quickly reconsider. Let's attack them. They have only weapons, and all I can see is an admittedly quite scary chain laser and a beam. But apart from that, I don't see a problem here, really. So we can't power this up until we get engines lower. Alright, so we definitely need reactor power, because we only have one bar of engine power. Technically, we have zero bars of engine power, actually. So we're going to send a drone part to hack their, we're going to hack their weapons first, just because it's best for us to keep those offline. And we'll wait until we see the charges on them doing what they do. When they get close to getting full, we'll react. So, basically, Ion Blast is just auto-fire, so let's control. And control, doesn't really matter where they hit, in my opinion at least. Okay, so they've charged. This disrupts their charging so much. If you're not following 100%, let me explain. When we cloak, their weapons don't charge. And then when we uncloak, we can hack them and then take their weapon charges down. So they'd like never get a chance to fire here. See, I am learning something from our kind of extended easy play here. So I'm going to land the Pegasus missile ideally on their shields. And then the pike beam can start doing damage. Our ions completely missed, but Pegasus did not. So they're going to be able to fire on us here, and that's where things get a little frightening, because they do have that scary chain laser, but Pike Beam will now be able to do damage and seriously cause them some issues, so that's going to really mess with them. That Mantis is going to have to destroy his own door to escape, because of the situation that we've created here. We can cloak, so we'll do that just to keep their weapons offline, even though they are offline already, sort of, to begin with. And I really want to make sure we hit the engine and piloting system with this pike bay, with this pike beam. So, ooh, that is really nice right there. That's fine. We don't need to hit their weapons because we can just hack them. We're not going to accept their surrender. We've learned our lesson. They won't be able to escape at all. We'll hack their weapons here. Not that it was even necessary because they had no charge, but yeah, they've got some issues here. I don't really want to use another Pegasus missile because there's just no point. Our energy shields only got hit once in that entire fight, so that will absolutely do it. Pretty good. Plenty of scrap there, so that's going to be one bar of reactor power for us, and that'll immediately go into the engines. We'll wait for our hacking unit to be ready to go again, and then we'll jump. I think we might need to wait. I don't know. It's about to be ready to go. More drone parts would actually be awesome, but sure. We don't really want to go to the store, to be honest with you. Just jump out this way instead. And out here, we get nothing. We're getting very close to Sector 8, I think. These videos are so freaking long, but that's okay. The overwhelming feedback was don't break them up, and I can understand that. You want to see, like, one run. You can break it up yourself if you want to, just by, you know, watching it in parts, so that makes way more sense. You detect multiple ships running at maximum power nearby, but you can't see anything through this thick nebula. Let's get closer! I'm doing it to basically because I feel like an offensive powerhouse. We're basically immune to threats right now. Let's hail them to see what's wrong. The Slug Captain explains that they upgraded the rock ship's reactor, and now the thick boulder heads, wow, offensive, are refusing to pay for the work done. The Rock Captain says the slime balls, jeez, these people, so ignorant, did a poor job that is not worth their agreed upon price. Let's pay it. For 11 scrap, we get one reactor power. That's way better than we would end up, than what we would pay to begin with, so I feel pretty good about that. Not bad at all. Looks like we're gonna have some fights here. The slugs here use a tactic you'd hope you'd never see. They use a remote hacking satellite to sabotage your oxygen production and then charge fire weapons. You're going to suffocate. Now we can counter their remote hacking. What happens? Your hacking system automatically counters the digital assault and you move in to fight the ship. Fuck you, slugs! I'm sorry, that was a little offensive. Now, our hacking system unfortunately is not available for this fight. What that means, it looks like our cloaking system's a little bit better. I'm just gonna fire control one. Control 2. Make sure our ion weapons are auto-firing. They're kind of worthless for us now that the enemies have so many shields, but it wears them down a little bit regardless. But really what I'm psyched for here is the Pegasus missile. So as soon as Pegasus missile is charged, that's going to be good. Our energy shield will protect us, but with three beams, I really do worry a lot about how quickly this energy shield is going to go down. So Pegasus landing there is super important. And now our ion blasts are actually way valuable, even though they missed there. So we lost a bar of shields. That's fine. Our cloaking's about to come back up. There we go. And as soon as ion blasts land, pike beam can then do what it does. As soon as one pike beam is able to land, that's basically the end of the enemy's existence. That's the end of their threat to us. So another Pegasus comes in. Thank God we have so many missiles. Oh, that is wonderful. Now, shields, doors, piloting system, and weapons. All gonna suffer some serious problems there. And now we just keep auto-firing our ion blasts, basically. They may have a small chance to repair as a result of their cloak, but level 1 cloak is not going to save them in this situation. Keep shields and weapons as ionized as we possibly can, and then the pike beam will finish the job. Fuck you, assholes! We got 56 scrap for that, so that's another reactor power. And again, remember, this is, like, at this point, we're not going to be able to, you know, defend well against missiles, so our main defense against missiles is dodging. Is that a good idea? Probably not. By the way, why did I get one extra bar of power? So we can upgrade our engines next, guilt-free, but for now we can at least keep one in our med bay, just as storage, basically. Every level of engine power is another 5% dodge chance. That actually could make a huge deal. Okay, so we're gonna counter their remote hacking. What did they hack? A slug ship hails you. We've detected worrying radiation coming from your medical unit. Perhaps you should take a look. As he signs off, your system shuts off and their crew teleports aboard from a nearby station. They don't look like engineers! Let's counter the remote hacking. You're able to undo the damage of their remote hacking satellite, but it's taking everything your hacking system has. Time to take out the enemy the old-fashioned way. Okay. This is fine as long as, Zoltan has to leave the weapons room. So we're gonna take one power away from our med bay, and then that should make it plausible to leave, and then our weapons are still fully powered. That's good. Why are our sensors not working? Because we're in a nebula. Okay, that's fine. We're gonna cloak, because they cloaked, so we're gonna cloak. Turnabout is fair play, I feel. We're just gonna go in the med bay, because then it's automatically powered up. They are also level 1 cloaking, which is meaningless. So, control. Alright, you know the deal. This is basically the same fight we had earlier. They're gonna seriously suffer from the lack of oxygen here, I would guarantee you that. We're just gonna send our engineer into the med bay. And we should close this door, but we can't now because I opened it. But that's fine, because it's just gonna make oxygen leak even faster. Really the most important thing for us here, if we're not gonna land every single, shot with our ion cannons, God, they have a lot of weapons, then we really need to land a Pegasus as soon as possible. So as soon as Pegasus is ready to go, we're gonna land it on their shields. Don't miss! I missed you guys, because they cloaked, but that's going to make this fight last a lot longer than I would like it to. Luckily, I think if we do this, why are we not auto-firing? Did auto-fire stop because of their cloak? If so, that's even better. I'm really worried about their, actually, you know what? They don't even have that much power. If they all fire their weapons all at once, why are you not firing? If they fire all of their weapons at once, that would be a problem, but they don't fire all of their weapons at once. They alternate consistently. Now we have a Pegasus missile stored up for when they come out of cloak, so this is an important one. Don't miss. Don't miss. One miss, one hit. I'll take it for now. I really don't know why my one Ion Blast refuses to auto-fire. Maybe it's because the Zoltan's not in there, but that seems to make no sense. So, everyone, go back to base. Go back to your positions. Now the one is... whatever. You know, it doesn't really matter. Pike Beam's gonna get a chance to shoot here, and that is where your life gets hard. Especially, you know, pretty hard to breathe without oxygen. Hope you don't mind. What about control 2, control 1? There we go, we finally got two auto-firing here. Inevitably, it was me making a mistake. I just don't know what that mistake was. So they're gonna come out of cloaking, which means I'm going to cloak. Our ions did not hit very well. So you know what? That's time for another Pegasus missile. They've got a huge dodge chance. And we'll do exactly the same thing that we did before. Should probably take out their piloting system or engine so that we don't have to worry about their dodge chance so much, but that's okay. No big deal. Still hitting them here. Taking out weapons. Not that they could actually do any damage to us anyway. And... okay, no pike beam yet. But we'll have a chance to cloak in just a second. There we go. We've cloaked. We missed with our ions. I could use another Pegasus missile, but I'd rather not. There we go. That's what I was looking for. And, there we go. This will kill them, presumably. Another fairly long fight, but they can't do damage to us. So we get 77 scrap. That is nuts. Oh, no, 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 no. Undo. We don't need an extra level of medbay right now. And we'll just get an extra bar of engine power. And we'll power it up. Do we need 4 bars of shields? That's the interesting question. I think the answer to that question is no, due to cloaking, hacking, our dodge chance, and the energy shield. But we'll see. Welcome to Uncle Joe's Fix-It Shop. Need a tune-up? We got you covered. Let's inquire about their specialty. They'll upgrade our door subsystem in exchange for some scrap. 25 scrap for a door system upgrade is actually a pretty good deal. So we'll get third level doors. May or may not end up making a difference, but that's okay. Onwards to the Zoltan-controlled nebula, or Zoltan-controlled sector in Sector 7. This is crazy. We're doing very well. It's going to be a very long video, and in a way I apologize for that, but also it's a good thing, right? It's a pretty nasty set of weapons they have there. So what I'm going to do is cloak right now. I just wanted to wait until their weapons were probably pretty charged, and then their cloak is going to come off. So I'm going to hack their weapons, and this should work while my cloak is still active. I can see their weapon charges, and as they get close, let's just get our weapons to auto-fire. As they get close to being fully charged, I'll just hack them so they don't get a chance to fire, and that should give us enough time, there we go, to get a either a pike beam, if possible, or a Pegasus missile landed on their shields, and then seriously mess with them. So here comes here comes the Pegasus missile. One hit, that's not enough, but maybe if both ions hit now, they both miss. The cloaking system comes up so quickly. Energy shield is our energy shield, I should say, is almost completely down. So what we're gonna do is we're not gonna cloak yet. We're gonna wait until like their beam gets very, very close to being ready. Which it is, but give it a second. Not yet. Stay on target. And we want to do this so that we're ready to hack when we come off of cloak. Okay, there we go. That's when we want to do it. Okay, so now they're not going to charge up anymore, and we should have a chance to get our hack up. There we go. Pike beam might save us from using a missile. I want to take out their cloaking system in addition to the shields, if possible. That'll... ugh. Let me... hey, that's good. That's all 5 important systems. This might save me from using a Pegasus, which is very important. Okay, and then we'll just hack their weapons. They actually did get a shot off, a couple of shots off, because I'm mad because I'm bad, but that's okay. As long as we can keep shields offline, we'll actually change one of the Ion Blasts to go on weapons now. They can't leave that room, remember, because of the hacking system's extra effect. So their beam does nothing. Our beam, on the other hand, is going to be quite cumbersome for them. They're going to try to escape. That's going to be difficult with no engines. Or at least inhibited engines. We actually missed a shot there. Much to my surprise, but Pike Beam will charge up pretty quickly. We'll just cloak so they can't charge up anymore. Their cloak did not work out very well for them. Our Pike Beam will now come in. Definitely want to hit piloting system, weapons, and engines. Their shields are not really coming back online anyway. They're going to surrender. We will not accept your surrender, unfortunately, for you. I don't know why I'm having so much trouble with auto-firing here, but that's fine. We'll just wait for Pike Beam to be ready. We might as well hack their weapon systems again. Why not? They actually could get away here if I'm unlucky. Please tell me I'm lucky. Oh, wait, they got away even though there was an explosion. Well, we missed out on some scrap there, but that's okay. Let's jump a little bit more. We're almost in the final sector, which is crazy town. Alright, it's an NG ship. They got a lot of nonsense going on here. Defense drones are going to be a serious counter to our... They have a huge ion and a couple of lasers. Let me think about this. We could go on their shields. I mean, hacking the shields seems... Or sorry, the way we want to do this is we want to use hacking on something, either weapons or shields, and then the Pegasus missile on the other. Because those are our two most, like, devastating, disruptive things. Or we could use them on the same thing. But I think we might want to hack the drone control unit. And I say this, we'll see if this is a terrible idea. They destroyed the drone as it came in. This is a scary situation here. We may just want to actually FTL and jump away. I'm just trying to think about how we want to handle this. Because if their drones shoot all of our missiles, we just can't do damage to them. So I'm thinking, it's okay, Tomo, don't worry. I'm thinking what we want to do is just kind of, we'll wait this one out and we'll jump away and nobody is going to be the wiser as a result. Our Pegasus missile would just bounce off of them. And the Zoltan energy shield, thankfully, gives us a really good opportunity to just leave. Alright, more coffee for me then. The drone isn't looking for you, perhaps it's scouting ahead for the Rebel expansion. Maybe they're seeking to use this nebula for cover, regardless it identifies yous. Okay, that's my redneckness coming out a little bit. We're gonna fire our hacking. Hacking on weapons actually just seems to work so well, but I accidentally fired it at shields there, so we'll make do, I suppose. We'll wait until at least the ions are ready to go. But to be honest with you, it's probably better to wait until the pike beam's ready to go. So let's just fire. We'll just auto-fire here to start with. And that's pretty good. Pike beam's now ready, so we'll hack the shields and we'll see if this works out for us. Okay has done a pretty good job. Could fire a Pegasus missile in here, but I feel like there's no need. Instead, we just wait for the pike beam to be ready with an ion blast landing. Nope, okay, so we Pegasus on the shields. They're not going to be able to hurt us. They don't have a missile. So ions come in, and then the pike beam is ready. Alright, that's really, really bad for you. Okay. I didn't go for drone control because I figured we'd lower their dodge chance instead. They're not going to be able to do damage, or if they are able to do damage, it's going to be exceptionally lucky on their part. So more power to them, you know? Alright, so pike beam's going to be ready to go, and this time we will hit the drone. Didn't kill it. That's okay, though. We could fire another Pegasus missile, but there's really no point. We might as well just keep our beam ready to go, and that'll be the end of this one. Very, very long video. But that's not the end of the world. 71 scrap is fucking amazing. There we go. We'll take an extra bar of that. We need more reactor power as well. But that's okay. We could also buy another weapon from the store. Maybe we want to sell one of our ion blasts or both of our ion blasts and pick up a better weapon. You arrive at a Zoltan security checkpoint and set up a perimeter around the beacon traveling vessel. You will submit to crew profiling to identify fugitives of the Empire. Let's submit to profiling. I feel like we have nothing to hide. Good, they allow us to pass. Of course, if we fought them, that might have ended up being the right decision, because by fighting them, we might have gotten some more scrap. But what are we fighting with here? Oh my god. It's a pulsating star. A rebel ship is here. Lasers. Hacking. Clone bay, I think. It might be a backup battery. Man, I just realized I've not used the backup battery, like, at all. What's the point in buying it if I'm not going to use it? But it was cheap. Okay. Let's backup battery. We should just do that at the start of a fight anyway. Get our dodge chance up. Why not? Do we cloak right away? I don't think so. Instead, I think we go, and we hack the weapons area. And we do this, and you know the drill by now. We wait until their weapon's nearly charged. Then we cloak, so the weapon stops charging. And we'll get our weapons auto-firing as well. Assuming it actually works this time. And then when our cloak runs out, they'll be ready to fire right away. Which they are about to do. And we'll, hack their weapons so they actually lose some charge. And that's wonderful. What does the ion pulse do? Disrupts shields and drones. Well, that seems like it'd be bad for them more than me, but whatever. We did lose some shield power there. Pike beam is actually ready to go right away, which is rare, to say the least. This will seriously cause them some problems. I bet if I started a little higher, we can actually hit all the... Not quite. Okay, well, hitting shields is way more important than hitting engines for us, so that's fine. Alright, we don't need to use a Pegasus missile. They're gonna hack us. They hacked our engines. That's not the end of the world. It will really mess up our dodge chance, but we're still, like, if we wanted to jump away, we still totally could. Pike beam is ready to go again, so we're basically just going to land it in exactly the same place. and that's just going to continue to make their life harder. Our shields have basically gone completely down, which actually gave them an opening, much to my chagrin. So, we're just going to cloak for a minute, and that's fine. Do I automatically have stealth weapons or something like that? I don't understand why I'm able to fire when cloaked, but whatever. That's not the end of the world. They want to surrender. I'm not going to accept it at this point. We've gone through too much. My piloting system got hit, actually, much to my surprise. It's all because of this fucking drone, because of the star that we're next to here. That's really disrupting my power. That's okay, though. I think we're still going to get more for not surrendering, even if we do have to spend some of it on repairs. So, Pike Beam, go to town. Thank you very much. We should probably jump away. Is there a store? We can jump to a store. We have the fuel necessary to do this, so this is fine. Necessary to get away, I should say. Okay, so we're just going to see what the store's got for sale. An ion blast and a hull beam requires 2 power. I'm just thinking. We could buy a lot of things here. If we sold both of our ion blasts, we still have Pegasus and Pike Beam. And then we could have a hull beam as well. So we'd have 2 beam weapons, but if the Pegasus missed, we would be in a really tough spot. But the ion weapons aren't doing anything for us. So I do think that this is maybe the best thing for us to do. I hope this didn't just completely fuck us. In addition, might want to heal up a little bit. That's fuel. Might want to heal up a little bit. Yes, I saw these and I thought, you know, maybe stealth weapons would be good, but it doesn't seem to be working in our, or against us anyway. I thought drone parts will be useful. And yes, obviously we'll take a second here to repair the shit out of everything on our ship. And does anyone need healing? Yeah, we need some healing. Osted, where are you? You're the pilot. You should come into the medbay then. And who else? Elizabeth needs a little bit of healing. Alright, so we want our hull beam to be ready. We're gonna need a Zoltan in the room. We don't need a Zoltan in the room. But we should get a Zoltan in the room. We are going to the 8th sector. It could be, this could be the miracle we've all been waiting for. Now we can get hull beam, but that costs us shield. Now we want medbay depowered. That's pretty much what we want, I guess. Seems right. Yeah. Okay. So the next thing we probably want, if I had to guess, would be a third bar of cloaking. Because the longer we're cloaked... Yeah, this is fine. The longer we're cloaked, the better our life is going to be, because we can actually get a chance for our Pegasus to charge. Because the Pegasus is now what has to do damage. We participated in the Zoltan study. You shouldn't have, apparently. But this is okay. It's always okay when this happens. So they have a missile launcher, ion, a laser, and a beam. That's the whole shebang right there, isn't it? We're gonna cloak now. I wanted to do it so their cloak will probably come off soon. And then we're going to hack their weapons. Just a smart thing to do as long as they can't fight back against it. Zoltan is going to go in here, which means we need one more bar of like surplus weapon power to keep everything powered up, which we have. As soon as we come off cloak, we're going to hack the weapons so they can't fire. Not as soon, but very soon after. There we go. That's perfect. Their intruders are going to die very soon. And we just need Pegasus to come back. Otherwise, and that the good news is we still have a huge, like, period of safety because we just, like, we have the energy shield still backing us up here, but it can go down pretty quickly. But now, okay, Pegasus lands on shields. This is the moment of truth. Pegasus land. Oh, no! You dirty scoundrels! You fought back against it. This is probably right now seeming like a very bad idea. I have high hopes, though. They just fired a missile. We're gonna dodge it. That should work out very nicely. And then we'll be able to hack right after we come back as well. We have someone in the weapons room now, so that's good. Their charges are not that high, so we can actually buy ourselves a couple more seconds here as their charges go up. There we go. That's the perfect hacking time. They're not going to cloak again in time for the Pegasus to be there, so here we go. That's perfect. And now we pike beam and hull beam the same time. Even though hull beam does better against empty rooms, it's so much smarter for me to just fire both of these. Maybe not simultaneously. Simultaneously, but near simultaneously. You know what I mean? I think maybe we'll try this one like from the other direction, like so. Can we get? That's good enough. I'll take it. There. Okay, that was pretty good. I wouldn't necessarily say it was wonderful, but we did some serious damage to them, whereas we're not really inhibited at all here. We will be able to cloak soon. I did hit their cloaking system a little bit, so they actually can't stay hidden for as long as they would probably want to be. So again, standard, wait for their weapons to almost be ready, then we cloak. And then when we come back from cloaking, we should be able to hack, but might not be necessary. Because Pike Beam is just going to do one of these bad boys. Maybe even... That's five, so we'll do it that way. And then Hull Beam, we're going to do like the opposite. We're going to trace it like this. So two beams, as you can see. Look at that. That just did like 12 damage to them in one fell swoop. That's amazing. So we got a boarding drone and just a ton of resources, which is wonderful. We need some reactor power. I picked up two bars, even though two bars might be overkill. Or it might be exactly what we need to even have our medbay powered up. So now we can put one more bar in engine power. And again, fourth bar of shields. Is it valuable? Yes, we could use a fourth bar of shields. Don't get me wrong. This guy's a store. So we can sell our boarding drone, because there's no way at this point we can imagine that we're going to get a boarding drone. A clone bay would replace our medbay, but I don't think it's that important. I also don't think that a small bomb benefits us that much. So what does benefit us? Healing and drone parts and healing. All right, let's get ready basically to head to Sector 8. I had a feeling it might happen because we're on easy. I'm really starting to dig the Zoltan cruiser though. A ship with a conspicuous pirate marking is orbiting a nearby moon, broadcasting a simple message claiming to have equipment available for sale. Let's hail the ship. The ship responds, yes, we have an extensive stock. Come aboard and see our wares. Dock with the ship. This seems dangerous. Leave or hacking disable their weapon system before docking. That seems smart. You receive a hail as soon as the hacking system finishes. What have you done? You can never trust a Federation ship. Here, take your standard toll. I should really do business elsewhere, scum. Wow, all right. So we basically just extorted that man, or, you know, alien, and we ended up, winning as a result. So there, that's what I was hoping for. We got a Zoltan cruiser as a result of this. So this is, I might as well go through this because we haven't been here. Your explanation is met with murmurs of cynicism and disbelief among the officers. General Terzel of the NG Brigade speaks up. Intel suggests potential counter to rebel technology. Risk all or save none. Explain the weakness of the enemy fleet, the rebel flagship. Okay, so they've given us, extra healing as well as 10 scrap. Now, the flagship will destroy the Federation base if it spends three consecutive turns there. The red rotating flagship icon indicates its position, which is here. When the jump line from the ship is solid, it will jump to the indicated beacon on that turn. Repair stations partially repair for free. So first things first, we have to try to get into the zone where the enemy is going to be. But we have to fight some ships along the way as well. Or we could just fly away, because our FTL is actually really good. Alright, so they do not have cloaking, but they do have drones. So I'm going to hack their weapons, and I'm doing it pretty much just to see what their charge is at. Oh no, they killed it before it came in. Okay, so what we're actually going to do is cloak right away, just so they can't get a charge. That's understandable that they would destroy our drone on its way in. We may not be able to FTL away in time, but I think we might be able to. A Pegasus missile is not going to do anything. What I want to actually try here is what if we do a pike beam and a hull beam at like exactly the same time. Can we actually get through their shields this way? Just in case the Pegasus ends up being unusable? No, it doesn't do anything at all, really. All right, so we're still protected here. So this is what I was basically hoping for, is that we can just jump away if necessary. They're gonna go here on this turn, so we're gonna go... Man, it's actually really difficult for us to get to that beacon. But I guess we should get to the base, because we need to protect it. And they're gonna go to the base, so that's where we wanna be. Okay. Sensors indicate that the rebels are setting up a forward jump beacon behind the planet's nearby moon. More importantly, a number of ships are passing by. Prepare to fight. Pretty much exactly the same situation here. I think if we spend a drone part, it'll just be completely wasted. Why is our cloning system out? Maybe because I jumped too quickly? That makes sense, you know? I fully understand that. We should just cloak, and we're gonna jump away again. Eventually, we're gonna have to fight the rebels, right? And I'll figure out how to do this. One thing that's important to note is that the rebel... I should put it this way. The only way that we can actually get through to the enemy is if a Pegasus missile lands. In order to make that happen, we're going to need to disable drones. So it might be necessary to hack a drone unit. We'll see. It looks like there's just nothing here. So they're going to come here on this turn, and we're going to get a chance to fight the flagship, which is wonderful. Let's try it. All right, this is it, the rebel flagship. They do not have drones, but they do have hacking. So what I'm actually going to do is see if they hack right away. No, they cloak right away. If they hack, then I cloak. Get ready, get ready, get ready. We're going to cloak anyway. We're going to cloak 3, 2, 1 now. Just so they can't stealth weapons out of their cloaking. Okay, give it a second. Now we're going to hack their weapons. Oh, but they have so many weapons bays. I remember now. Hacking their cloaking might not be the worst thing, but I think we're going to hack shields first. And we can always send another one, I think. That looks like it went on their piloting system, but didn't, so that's fine. So we're not going to go on shields yet, obviously. Now is the moment of truth. How long will our energy system last against these new weapons? That remains to be seen. Pegasus missile's about to go here, but I think we're probably going to have to wait for them to cloak once. We have a 48% dodge chance. Oh, the missile's basically missed. Okay, that's wonderful. Now, this is the moment of truth. Oxygen's going down here. That's fine. That's fine. As long as it stops soon. They've hacked our oxygen system. Oh, that seems dangerous. Give it a second. It'll come back. I have faith. Okay, we cloaked. That's perfect. This is extremely important. Hack the shields. Pegasus the shields. And just see. Enough landed. I think that crew member will die in there. Their shields are still high, though. But this is fine. We at least got one fell swoop in there. Oxygen got real nasty there, actually. It would be nice to get a second level of that. This poor crew member is screwed. Hopefully they do not have a fire suppression system. I'm going to send our NG in here to repair the sensors. The medbay, less important for now. Sensors, critically important. Okay, you know what? I think they're going to cloak soon, but we can instantly do damage with pike beam. So I'm going to pike beam plus, see if we can stop their hacking system too. If we get their pike beam plus the hull beam simultaneously, I think that we can take out their shields enough to actually do damage. Please tell me I'm not wrong. They cloaked. So that's why I didn't want to fire a Pegasus missile, and I think that was a smart idea. So oxygen's going to drop like crazy again. Obviously, this is scary. Sensors are back up. You come back over here and fix the med. Now, you go into the shield room. We don't need the med bay. So we're going to get ready to cloak. Oxygen's going to be bad in a second. Actually, you should fix the med bay because we're going to need to heal people if oxygen gets poor. All right, now we cloak. We cannot hack because the systems are completely disabled. Okay, this is a good moment for us. Got to take out their cloaking system. Pegasus will do it. People are going to start to take damage here in a second due to the oxygen. Now, pike beam and hull beam can do their work. As soon as they charge up, anyway. Give it some time. Give it some time. And we may have to put everybody inside of the med bay to heal once oxygen gets super low. But okay, that's okay. We're just going to try to do as much damage as possible. Hull beam does two damage per empty room. So we can hit four of them here. That'll be eight damage. And then with our pike beam, we'll hit the important systems. Yes, their weapons are dangerous, but I think hacking and cloaking are more dangerous for me right now because of the oxygen problem. So, oh, this is wonderful. It's going to work. They might take enough hull damage to actually just, I don't want to use a Pegasus here if possible. Their cloaking system still works, really. Okay, here we go. Oxygen's going to be bad. You know what? Everyone get to the med bay here. Med bay. And the pilot will be fine. The pilot goes down with the ship. Oh, that's bad. Fire in the med bay. Fire at the Taco Bell. Here we go. Three rooms with the hull beam. That'll take out the first phase of the Rebel flagship. Oh, this is so bad. I'm thinking about this. How quickly, if we open all doors, oxygen will come back in, I think. Are we going to lose like all of our crew to this? Oh, please, please, the oxygen's coming back. There's nothing we can do about this. We just have to give them a chance to fix up the med bay. People are going to die, definitely. Lots of people. I don't know what this green blob is. Oh, it's because it's paused. That was them exploding. You can do it, NG. Okay, the NG did it. We lost two crew members in the process. Due to their systematic dismantling of some very important systems, but that's okay. That's okay. We got through the first phase. The second phase is still bullshit, but we got through the first phase. So let's get in here, fix it up. Everyone's gonna be okay here. All we gotta do is finish the fight for our friends, you know? And this, you know, reminds you, in FTL, easy still ain't easy. Now, how do we want this layout to work? One engine power down, shields up as high as they can go. You get in the pilot system, you get over here, you get into the shields. Now, what's the, are you a second level shields? No, you're not even close. Why don't we put you on weapons then instead? Evade chance is 35? What if we put you on, on the engines. Evade chance then becomes 40. What can we upgrade that would help us? I think upgrading oxygen would help us. So we're going to get one bar of that. Why don't we get one bar of shields as well? Sorry, sensors. That's what I meant, actually. Okay, and we can always use backup battery, which I should actually, you know, do. So here we go. We're gonna try the second phase of the Rebel fleet. This should be interesting. It's stupider now. They actually have drone control units, which may be able to shoot my hacking, my drone part out of the sky. But we're gonna land this. They don't have cloaking anymore. We're gonna land this on their shields, if possible. No, they. Oh, they didn't get it. They missed. Okay, extremely important. So what we're actually gonna do now that we're on their shields is take a second here to cloak, like so. We should use our backup battery just to get extra evade chance. Why not, right? And I guess we might as well power up the oxygen in the meantime, or the med bay. It doesn't really matter. So we're waiting for everything to get charged, basically. Most important thing is that a Pegasus missile lands on their shields. So we're going to hack shields, and then a Pegasus comes in at the same time. Power surge detected. I hate this bullshit. I forget what it does, but I hate it. Okay, so they've boarded us as well. And they're gonna fight us. They're gonna break our sensors. That's meaningless to me. Fuck it. I don't care. I don't know how we're gonna fight him. Oh, this is not good. Okay. NG, you're on repair duty now. Yeah, okay. Actually, this is probably our... Oh my god. Okay. As long as our weapons don't get hurt, we're okay for now. We can cloak pretty soon, as long as the cloaking gets healed soon enough. Pegasus has gotta come in. Pegasus has gotta come in. Shields are back up. Pegasus lands. Hacking is next. Cloaking is next, actually. Okay! We cloaked, which should give us enough time. And then we're gonna... Oh, you know what? We're actually gonna hack right now. And... Does it do anything? Not too much, huh? Okay, they still got two bars of shields. Now get in here and fix the engines as quickly as you freaking can. The oxygen's meaningless at this point. Okay, now you need to go fix the oxygen. It became less meaningless in a hurry. This is the most important Pegasus missile of our lives. And you know what? The pilot's going to get in here as well to put out this fire, because it's got to happen quickly. Pegasus missile lands. Okay. But didn't do enough damage. Oh, it's so scary. Our hacking unit's down now. I don't know if we can win this one. Oxygen's not important. The hacking unit's important. Go fix... Okay. You go to the shields. You go to the hacking unit. Oxygen level 1 is fine. Oh, there's another fire in the hacking bay, of course. Okay, okay, we cloak. We have to cloak. We have to cloak. This is, yes, frightening. The most important Pegasus missile of our lives, part 2. Now, you get in here and help put out this fire, man. You can do it. I have oh, weapons are down. It's only the Pegasus. We're dead. We're dead, but we got so fucking close. We tried, at least. It was a lot of fun. What's our score? It's gotta be up there. 28-48. It's... our best ship with, or it's our second best run with the nether ship. That was a lot of fun. And now we unlocked Zoltan Sea, but I hope you enjoyed this episode. It's been a freaking long one. As always, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But as always, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the run, and I'll see you next time.